On Mother's Day weekend, my mom and I enjoyed our trip to the Sea Lion Caves to celebrate their 75th anniversary, which was on May 13th. They also had an unveiling of a hand-carved totem pole depicting the indigenous sea creatures. Artist Margaret and her husband Steve were on hand, and they proudly spoke of their vision.
And this totem pole is going to be here for a very long time. It's going to see generations come and go. And it's going to look at the highway, it's going to look at the cave, it's going to look at the ocean and the lighthouse. And it has a presence. It's not magical, but if you come up and touch it, you might feel its presence.
Steve Saubert acted as master of ceremonies, recognizing four generations of ownership between the Saubert, Jacobson, and Houghton family partnership started in 1934. At that time, Highway 101 was fairly new and only gravel. The difficulty and danger of constructing the 1,500-foot-long trail and 135-stair-step wooden tower was enormous. Yet the three families took the responsibility seriously. Today, the Sea Lion Caves are one of Oregon's golden treasures, recognized by the Guinness Book of Records as the largest sea cave in the world and home to the stellar sea lion species. This variety of sea lion is commonly called the northern or stellar sea lion, named after George Steller, a German naturalist and explorer in 1741. Like other species, the Steller's numbers are in decline on the central coast of California and north to the Bering Sea and south to Japanese waters. However, in Oregon, the Sea Lion Caves average 200 a season. Many dignitaries were on hand to applaud the accomplishment of the families who have dedicated their life to the conservation and preservation of these magnificent creatures. I was impressed by the sincere pleasure that everyone demonstrated at the celebration. It reminded me of what can be accomplished with vision and dedication. Once again, the people of Oregon maintained greatness by coming together for a common cause, to save the stellar sea lion. I hope you'll take a trip this spring and summer to see for yourself. Located 11 miles north of Florence on US Highway 101, I'm sure you'll enjoy your time as much as my mom and I did. For Oregon Living Television, I'm Kathy Kingsbury.